The Caprice condo building on JFK Boulevard is the latest casualty in Jersey City's knockdown, drag-out fight this election cycle. It has nothing to do with a candidate or a political issue. The most contentious vote on the ballot this year is about an existing ordinance regulating Airbnb listings.
The developer misled the city to get a subsidy and then is using Airbnb as a tool to create more revenue for himself and more revenue for Airbnb.
Jersey City Mayor Steve Phillips says the city's Division of Taxation recently put the developer of this 83-unit complex on notice for defaulting tax abatements received since 2013. Instead of opening a residential building, the city contends it became an illegal hotel with the help of Airbnb, allowing hundreds of transient visitors to cycle through. Just one example out of many, the administration cites urging residents to vote yes on ballot question one, keeping government regulations in place.
Airbnb, I think, is not concerned about the community well-being. They're concerned about being in the New York media market here, the New York market, and protecting their IPO next year.
Now, because the city hasn't carried through with regulation, they're using this opportunity in order to make a political point and mislead the voters.
Liz DeBold-Fusco with Airbnb argues the regulations overreach, calling it an all-out ban. Voters will decide November 5th whether Jersey City should keep in place rules governing listings, including a cap on short-term rentals if the owner doesn't physically live on site.
It bans all renters from being able to share their homes. No ifs, ands, or buts. Bans short-term rentals in any building with four or more units.
If you want to know just how much is riding on this, you need only look to the most recent ELAC reports. According to those, Airbnb has given nearly $3.3 million to the group Keep Our Homes. That's the group urging residents to vote no to repeal this ordinance. Meanwhile, two groups who are opposed to Airbnb urging residents to vote yes have raised and spent nearly $900,000. Those groups are linked to the Hotel Trades Council and Hotel Industry, and each side of the fight has dueling data sets to discredit the other. For example, the group Keep Our Homes, aligned with Airbnb, points to a study by an e-commerce lobbying group called Internet Association. The data claims short-term rentals created $40 million in economic activity in Jersey City last year.
You line up who's asking for a yes vote in a reasonable support of reasonable and fair regulations. It is dozens upon dozens of credible organizations. And on the other side is Airbnb and dollar signs.
Meantime, a community activist and data analyst behind the website Inside Airbnb collected data showing that just 10 hosts in Jersey City are responsible for nearly 600 listings.
Can you speak to these so-called, you know, bad actors, these folks, these 10 listings, these 10 hosts who have a monopoly on these listings, who have hundreds of listings? These are not people who are just renting out rooms in their houses.
I would say two things to that point. The first is that, again, there are regulations that are in place that the city never implemented around short-term rentals. Again, requiring hosts to register more than five listings. The city never implemented that.
The question has flyers flooding mailboxes, signs posted around town, even canvassers going door to door. In a letter dated October 16th, a handful of Jersey City residents allege harassment and intimidation by residents supporting the regulations, citing trespassing damage to their properties and physical threats.
It's just politics. You're there 3 weeks away from an election, and they feel that they're in jeopardy. So
you don't think that the claims are substantial?
I haven't heard anything like that. You know, the fact that they send out a press release when they send out a letter is suspect. I haven't seen any police reports.
Both sides say false information is being spread.
Anyone who votes yes, and if this ordinance were to be upheld in a referendum, cannot be amended for 3 years.
The question is whose argument will be convincing at the polls. In Jersey City, Brianna Venosi, NJTV News.